hello, and welcome to this week's broadcast. I am Anne LaFollette, a surface pattern designer, online educator, and creative entrepreneur. And we have just started my free mini course, From Doodles to Dollars. It's not too late for you to join us. And this is the last time I'm offering this free mini course in 2021. So I thought to help you get started, I would replay today lesson number one for you. And then at the end of the video, I'll remind you where to go to sign up. Because as I mentioned, it's not too late for you to join us. This is the last time I'm offering the program in 2021. So let's jump in to lesson number one. Well, hello, my friend. I am Anne LaFollette, a surface pattern designer, online educator, and creative entrepreneur. And let me be the very first to welcome you to this free mini course, From Doodles to Dollars. I only offer this program twice a year, and you are in for a real treat. Before I tell you what we're going to cover today, let me just tell you a little bit about myself. I had a 25-year corporate career in retail. I worked for big companies that you would recognize, like Sears, Esprit de Corps, The Gap, and Old Navy. And actually, in my late 50s, I got called into my boss's office, and he sat me down and said, "Anne, we've just eliminated your job. Walk down the hall and go talk to human resources." And this came as a complete shock. I was a top performer. I was a type A student. I worked really, really hard and had worked my way up the ladder all the way to the vice president level. And I thought I would retire from the company with a gold watch and, you know, the proverbial retirement party. Not so much. So the reason I share this story with you is because my mom told me at the time that when one door closes, another one opens. And that has ended up being so true for me. With the support of my wonderful husband and my son and my family, I was able to completely reinvent myself. Let me tell you, it wasn't an easy journey necessarily, but I am in a very joyful place now, where I not only absolutely love creating designs and getting them licensed as a surface designer, but I also love to teach how to do it, because it's an incredibly huge industry with so many opportunities. And that's what I'm excited to share with you in this mini course. So in the mini course, I always like to share the journey that we're on together, and then we're going to jump in to the first lesson. So here's how I like to start. What you see on screen is the roadmap for our Doodles journey that we're going to go on together for the next 2 weeks. Lesson number one, which we're going to do today, is to sketch and import your artwork into Adobe Illustrator. Then in lesson number two, I'll show you how to image trace that artwork and add color to it. Then in lesson number three, you'll create a beautiful repeating pattern using the elements you've now added color to. And then finally, lesson number four is saving and exporting your work so that you can have custom fabric made, or wrapping paper, or wallpaper, or a variety of different products. At the end of the mini course, I will be opening enrollment to my 10-week Pattern Design Academy program, and I'm super excited about it. It has been completely updated, so it's current with Adobe Illustrator 2021, but more about that later. Let me show you some images now of some of the patterns that I have made, because I want you to see that some of them are very, very simple. In this image, you can see that some of the wrapping paper is just little pieces of rice that I repeated over and over again. So as you start to think about sketching, here's an example of one little imaginary flower, and I just sketched it in a bunch of different directions. So it's a little bit more interesting than just having, for example, one of them. But this workshop is not all about flowers. You absolutely can pick something else. So here's an example of some drawings that I did of my koi watercolor tubes. And I think they came out really, really cute. My advice is for you to keep to just 3 to 5 elements. Now, of course, I'm showing you flowers again, but you could pick animals. You could pick little dots and squiggles. You can really pick whatever you want. And the idea that I'd like to get across in this first lesson, and you'll hear me say this throughout the mini course, is that I want to get you to the finish line. And so that means I don't want you to get too hung up on creating the most beautiful repeating pattern in the universe. I want you to pick something that's relatively easy so you can actually focus on learning the step-by-step process we're going to go through to turn a sketch into a repeating pattern. And there's some pretty involved steps that we're going to go through together. And once you've done them successfully once, then you can focus more on the artwork itself. Here's just another little example to show you of some of the most popular items that I have in my shop. And the mug is just lines and dots and little V shapes. And again, the wrapping paper is essentially just little ovals that look like pieces of rice. So as you jump into your homework assignment, which is to create 3 to 5 elements, don't forget to download your sketch and import guide. A link to the guide was included in the email that you received this morning that contained this video in it, so make sure that you download it. It contains do's and don'ts, some additional sketching tips, and some information on how to help you take a really good photo of your sketch, because your homework assignment is to actually draw 3 to 5 elements in your sketchbook, take a picture of them, and then I'm going to show you how to import that picture into Adobe Illustrator, because lesson number 1 is all about sketching and importing. So the key thing about taking a photo is just make sure that there isn't a shadow on it and that you're putting your phone over, like right above your sketchbook, but you can read more details in the guide itself. Now, if you have a scanner, fantastic. You can scan your image into the computer, but I'm just going to assume that many of you don't, and so you can absolutely just take a picture with your phone. Now, let's move into the computer, and I'll show you how to bring that either scanned image or photograph into Adobe Illustrator. And again, there are written instructions for you in your downloadable guide so that you can follow along step by step. What you see on screen is my iMac. This is my desktop computer. And the first thing I want to point out is that my images that I'm going to bring into Adobe Illustrator are sitting right here on my desktop. Do you see my cursor? I'm moving my cursor over on the right-hand side of the screen, and I'm pointing at Wisps 1 and Wisp 2. I just brought this image in. I took a couple pictures of it to see which one I might like best. Now, I have Adobe Illustrator here along the bottom of my Mac dock. It's called the dock. And here it is right here, Adobe Illustrator 2021. Now, if you're on a PC, you're going to have to go into your systems to locate Adobe Illustrator. But essentially, all you need to do to open it is click on it. And when you see this image, you may not have a whole ton of documents down here because you may just be using the trial version of Adobe Illustrator. But you are going to definitely be able to follow along if you have the trial of Adobe Illustrator or if you've already purchased the 2021 subscription. So on this screen, the very first thing that we want to do is we want to create a new document. So do you see my cursor over here on the left? All we're going to do over here is we're going to click on Create New. And do you see when I hover over it, it changes from black and white to become almost all white? So I'm going to click just once. And then you get all of these sort of, it says new document up here at the top, and you got all kinds of things happening over here, and it can feel really confusing.
But we're going to keep things really simple, and we're going to pick, you might have an option right here for an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper. So I'm going to click on that, and it doesn't matter that it says mobile. All you want is an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper, because we all kind of know that as a reference point, at least here in the United States, and it's an A4 piece of paper for those of you who are in Europe or in Australia. Now, I want to point out, look at my cursor. I'm going to move it over here to the right. If you don't have an option that says 8.5 by 11, just come over here and you can enter. See this little width and height? If you click in width, you can enter 8.5. And then if you come down to height, you can enter 11. And then here's your little orientations. So we want it to be in this portrait orientation. One of the things you're going to notice, and we'll cover a lot in this mini course, is that there's lots of arrows either pointing down or pointing sideways. See the one I'm pointing at right now? If I click here, it's going to show me a whole bunch of other options that I could use in terms of units of measure. We're going to work in inches. We're not going to use a bleed. We're going to keep things really simple. We're not going to worry anything about advanced options yet either. Just going to go to this blue button and hit create. And now, let me tell you just a little bit about what you see on screen. So this is our piece of paper that has the black line around it. And the outside is what's called the canvas area. And this area that's inside this black line is called your artboard. And I'll get into artboards in a little bit later. But right now, my goal is to keep this as simple as possible, only teach you what you need to know to get to the finish line. So in this lesson, we sketched. Now we're on the import phase. Once you've opened a new document, you have to bring this cute little wisp thing in here. Now, there's a bunch of different ways to do it. And of course, one of the things you'll also hear me say a lot is there's tons of different ways to do the various things I'm showing you. So I'll always try to show you maybe one or two ways to do things. And then over time, you're going to become much more comfortable and you'll decide, well, which one works the best for you. So what I want to show you to do is how to bring this photograph in. And one really quick way is to grab it on your desktop, hold your finger down on your mouse so it's selecting it, and then slide it over. And you notice when I bring it onto the center, it had that little green dot on it. Then I released my finger, but look what happened. It's gigantic, right? It's gigantic. So that is not the best way to bring the image in. But the reason I wanted to show it is that sometimes people will do that because it's obviously super fast. Then it's like, whoa, how do I make this image small enough? Because we need to actually get it to fit inside our 8.5 by 11 piece of paper. So I am going to go to Edit, Undo Paste. Do you notice up here, I just moved my cursor all the way up to the top here, which says Illustrator, File, Edit. And under Edit, it says Undo Paste. So I'm going to click that to get rid of the image, because that's not how I want you to bring it in. The way I do want you to bring it in is I want you to go up to File, and then you'll see if you scroll down here, there's a word called Place. I want you to click on Place. Then what happens is it brings up all of the different places where you might have documents on your computer. I'm going to click on Desktop because I know those little wispy things are on my desktop. So I'm going to click on Desktop. And sure enough, you can see that I've got a Wisp 1 and a Wisp 2. They're super faint, but if I click on one of them, it becomes, you can see it much, much better. I'm just going to click on Wisp 1. And then look, I'm going to move my cursor all the way down to the right-hand side, lower right, where you have this blue button that says Place. Click on Place. Then notice what happens. The image is attached to my mouse, kind of virtually. And so what I want to do is I don't want to just click in here because then the same thing will happen and it'll be gigantic. I actually want to hold my finger down on my mouse. I'm just moving my mouse across my desktop. Now I'm going to release. And then that brings the image in a size that's manageable for me. It's a size that's inside this 8.5 by 11 piece of paper. So that is how I would recommend that you actually bring your document in. Now, as I mentioned, there is a guide. All of these steps are detailed in that guide. And so I want to make sure that you have that handy when you actually do this yourself. Once you've brought your image into Adobe Illustrator, the last thing we need to do before we end today's lesson is I want to make sure I give this file a name. Look at my cursor. I'm moving it up here. Do you see up here in the upper left-hand corner? It says untitled 4. We need to give it a name so we don't lose it. So I'm going to go to file, and then I'm going to go to save. I get a little pop-up box. I'm going to call this Wispy Flowers. And I want to make sure that when I come down here to the bottom, I want to make sure that the format remains Adobe Illustrator that has the little AI in parentheses. That's the format we want to keep because that is what we're going to work with in lesson number 2. I'm just going to come to the lower right, see this blue little save button. I'm going to click save. So I'm going to click OK. And now if I come back up to the upper left-hand corner, you can see I have a name, which is awesome. You can also see, if you come to my desktop, I moved all the way over to the right, you can see that I have wispyflowers.ai, which is the file format we're going to work with in lesson number 2. So now let's talk about your homework assignment and a couple of next steps.
Your assignment is to post your sketches in the comments below this beautiful picture that's inside our private Facebook group. So when you go into the Facebook group, look for this post with this beautiful image, and then you're going to click on the comments attached to this image and upload your sketches there. Now, I, of course, have this also detailed in the beautiful guide that you have. On the last page, you will see the step-by-step instructions about how to upload your sketch so that we can see what you're working on, we can celebrate each other, and we can continue to move forward in the process. Don't forget that I will also be live tomorrow inside Anne's Art Club at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time to answer your questions from this very first lesson. Before I let you go, I want to share this brilliant conversation that I had with Jane Foster. She's a sewing instructor and has always been in love with all things sewing, including always having a fantastic stash of fabrics, and she now has her own stash of fabrics that have her very own designs on them. So take a listen.
You're in for a real treat today because we're going to be talking to Jane about her amazing business and how she incorporated surface design into an existing creative business that she's been running for years.
I was born in a little seaside town called Seaton in Devon in England. Was there until 1981, and now I'm an American, and I live just outside of San Francisco, Walnut Creek, and I have been a teacher here for teaching adults now for the last 35 years. I first started sewing when I was 6 years old, and I can remember now how that made me feel doing some embroidery. It was amazing, as if I'd won a prize. And so that followed all the way through to 18. And I knew when I was 12 that I wanted to teach sewing. It's something I could do naturally. It was in me. My mother didn't sew one stitch. Just in me, I think. My grandmother just did mending. Coming to America and finding out that I could, I went to San Francisco and got my adult ed qualification. And so I, for the last 35, 40 years, I've taught adults here. And then I was blessed to be able to build this studio onto my house with some money from my mom and dad. And so I've taught everywhere, every store, everywhere. You know, adult education. But in fact, teaching now in my own studio is lovely.
So before we even go any further, I have to make sure that we're pointing out to everyone that the blouse you're wearing is one of your designs.
A tunic top, yeah.
Right? Is that just the most amazing? Look how gorgeous that flower is on your shoulder that is in the shot. It's like, wow, it's so beautiful. So
these are dahlias. You call them dahlias. We call them dahlias in England. And one of my students gave me 12 dahlias and I planted them. And so my pictures are magnificent. So then I drew them and then made them into spoonflower fabric.
Yeah, unbelievable. They're just gorgeous. So you have been obviously sewing all your life and teaching all of your life. Yeah. And so how did we meet? How did you come into my world?
I discovered you It's been a year now since I had to close the studio, just about a year since the studio closed. And dealing with the outside world and people dying and everything, I was very content to be in my studio and start sewing some of my stash. I have so much. My gosh, a studio to myself, not sharing it with six people. All this fabric over here, I can make up some of my things. And I did that for a couple of months, but then I was getting to a point where I thought, no, I got to do something else. And I think I found you online at Doodles to Dollars, a free course. And I thought, wow. And of course, my son worked for Adobe, so he would always be so proud of me if I did anything. And so I thought, oh, Adobe Illustrator, I could learn that. And so that's what I began to do with you. And then I kept thinking, paying for the 8-week course, I'm not earning any money. Oh, do it, Jane, do it. And so I did your academy course. And so every time you mentioned something new, off I went and did it. I did the wrapping paper.
Oh, it's fabulous.
I put my brother's art onto Christmas wrapping paper.
Oh my gosh, the Three Kings. That's lovely.
Yes, Three Kings. That was his. So I didn't know how to do it, but I put it in and recolored it and did that. So the thrill of receiving my first sheet of wrapping paper from
Stationery HQ, probably?
HQ was, yeah, the biggest thrill around. I can't believe it. And so I called it Liz, my daughter's succulent garden, because I'd gone out in the garden, picked some and drawn them. And then I had them. Then I had them made onto bone china mugs, and the thrill of giving those as gifts was amazing. So every time with your academy course, something came up, I got a label from Moo, and I did this and I did that, and I started to work with the mood board. You know, the mood,
yes, board.
Oh my goodness, amazing! So the mood board I chose was the seaside, the ocean, the seashore, and put that all together. And oh, I just loved it. It reminded me of, you know, the things at the sea. And I love just working with the tissue paper and putting it in.
Yeah.
Just amazing. Just amazing.
So you have to describe a little bit of your process. I'd love to know your work process, because you've mentioned photographs quite a bit, and then also that you're using tracing paper. So talk to us a little bit about how you like to work.
Well, I'm working in a sketchbook, as you say, suggested, drawing, getting it to a point I like, and then putting tracing paper over it and tracing it in ink, mm-hmm, putting it in my scanner, taking it in, and vectorizing it, and then the color part. I just love. And I will spend hours putting color in and out and changing it. My thrill is when my students buy it, and, you know, you'll see in my Instagram, one of my student Vicky's just made a dress, and Kathy made an apron for her sister, and they're gradually beginning to buy it, you know, which is so exciting for me. So exciting.
Yeah, it's fantastic. And so you do a lot of your sketching in your sketchbook, then you trace, yes, over it with a pen so that, yes, you can get a nice crisp line, then you scan it, yes, into Adobe Illustrator. I love those motifs. All of those are adorable and feel very Cape Coddy. And yeah,
that made this. So this is the collection that I did with my seashore.
It's
the mackerel boats, the pebbles on the seashore, the shells, the mackerel, the Devon ice cream.
It's beautiful fabric. Yeah, and then on the inside, you did the cute little changing cabins.
Beach huts, yes.
The beach huts.
My dad looked after those in the winter and put them out in the summer for the council.
What's great is to also hear how you embraced the process that I teach, both obviously starting with From Doodles to Dollars, but then in the Academy program where we, of course, go much deeper and talk about collections. And so, yeah, that seashore collection is just beautifully rendered with each of the motifs in a totally different way.
In the Academy, when you did a module on leaves, I went rushing out to the garden, picked up some leaves from the ground, brought them in, put them in my copier, put them in and developed this color range, which again is in my palette, believe it or not.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah, and of course this is in a knit, so it's lovely to wear for a t-shirt. It's just great, you know. And I changed the colors to
beautiful, to the blues and yellows.
And that's what Vicky bought, the leaf medley.
I just wanted to say again how incredibly grateful I am that you could spend this time with me and that I could both learn more about you and everybody in Anne's universe here can learn more about you. So what would you like to say to everyone in closing? Is there any message you want to leave people with?
Go for it. If you think you're busy, you are busy, but whenever you can fit it in, get some education for yourself in the things you love to do. I put it off for too many years, having to earn a living and whatever, but it's come to me now and it's such a blessing and such a joy. Anne has created such an amazing place for you to gain a lot of knowledge. And it's just such fun.
Thank you so much, Jane, for spending this time with me. This has been such a joy. But yes. I always like to say in closing that I am Anne LaFollette, and it's never too late to create. So thank you, Jane.
Bye, everyone. Bye-bye. Thank you.
I hope that you enjoyed lesson number one and that whet your appetite for more. Join us inside Doodles. This is the last time I'm offering the program in 2021. And you can enroll today and get all caught up. It's at members.artwithanne.com/from doodles to dollars. And there's a clickable link below this video. I always like to say in closing that I am Anne LaFollette, and it's never too late to create. Bye for now, and I'll see you in Doodles. If you enjoyed this broadcast, don't forget to pop over to my website, annelafolletart.com, and you'll land on a page that looks like this. If you scroll down just a little bit, I'm always highlighting in this banner area something new that's happening in my business or something that I would love for you to explore. And so always pop over here and check this area out. In addition, if you scroll down a little bit further, I'm always changing up my offerings in order to serve you best and continue to share the latest and greatest information about the surface design industry and how you can craft a career that you love in pattern design. If you scroll all the way to the bottom of the page, you can follow me on Instagram and then also pop over to my YouTube channel. And I would love for you to hit the red subscribe button as well as the little bell so that you're notified whenever I have a new broadcast. Thank you so much for being a part of my creative community, and bye for now.